Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Bansal Biology. In today's video, I am going to explain complementation test. So first of all, if we see, the complementation test is only applicable for the homozygous mutation condition. The first condition for complementation test that it occurs, it is applicable only for the homozygous mutation condition. That is when the mutation is on both the alleles, when the mutation is on the both alleles, in this allele and in this allele, only then the mutation will be expressed. If it is on one, it won't be expressed. It won't be expressed. It must be on both the alleles. That is homozygous mutation, and that is one of the condition of complementation test. Now, if we see what is complementation test. So, complementation test is to find out that for a characteristic, two genes are coding for that specific characteristic or only one gene is coding. What I say that for example, if I take a specific example of color. For example, in flower, if the flower is of purple color. So that purple color flower, that pigment is coded by two genes or it is coded by one gene. Or we can say that the allele or the genes are present on different loci or on same locus. Ki ये अगर पर्पल कलर का फ्लावर है तो इसको कितने जीन्स ने कोड किया या फिर जो जीन्स है वो सिमिलर लोकस पे प्रेजेंट है या डिफरेंट लोकस पे प्रेजेंट है, सेम लोकस पे प्रेजेंट है या डिफरेंट लोकस पे प्रेजेंट है उसके जो अलील्स, ये फाइंड आउट करने के लिए व्हाट वी डू अ कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन टेस्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी टेक टू केसेस. इफ आई टेक द फर्स्ट केस एंड इन फर्स्ट केस आई एम कंसीडरिंग दैट द two genes are responsible for purple color of flower. Two genes are responsible for the purple color of flower. So if I take that the flower in the initial condition during its development was of white color, obviously it will be a white color until and unless the pigment is formed and the white color is formed into the purple. So during the initial growth, it was of white color. After that, gene A is expressed. Gene A is expressed, still it is of white color. But when gene B is expressed, it is converted into the purple color. So from this I am getting that both gene A and gene B are needed for the formation of purple color. If there is mutation in any of them, in gene A or gene B, the purple color is not formed. So I will take one example. The first one is gene A is mutated. What happened? Gene A is mutated. Then what will happen? First it was white color. Then what happened? A is mutated. So AA, as we are discussing, taking homozygous mutation. So AA, still white color. Gene B is normal, no mutation, but the color of the flower is white color. Why? Because the gene A is mutated and we need gene A for the formation of blue color, purple color. Next, if we second take gene B is mutated. So once again, white color flower was in starting. Development occurred, gene A expressed still white color. But now the gene B is mutated, still white color. Why white color? Because we need gene B for the formation of purple color. So in both cases, what happened? The color is white. The flower color is white. So now what we'll do? We take two parents, two pure breed, and we cross them. Both the parents are mutated. both parents are what? Mutated. Mutated as in both are of white color. White color, white color. Both are pure breed. As in this, the gene A is mutated and B is normal. And in this, A is normal but B is mutated. In this what? B is normal. And in this, A is normal. But still, both will be white colored. Now what happened? Gametes will be formed. Here also, gamete will be formed. And the offspring. Offspring will be A, A, B, B. Ye the gametes, this was gamete and the offsprings are A, capital A, capital B, small b. Now what will be the color of the offspring? Will it be white or will it be purple? It will be purple. As one allele is present for the coding of the purple color. As we have said that homozygous mutation can only be seen for the mutation result or as the wild type offspring will be formed. So here what happened? Here mutation is present but the wild type allele is also present. So what happened in this that the parents were mutated but the offspring is wild type. So in this condition, gene A and gene B complemented each other. Gene A and B complemented each other. And this can only occur when there are two loci present, or we can say two genes are present. Genes are present on the different loci. This thing can only occur at that time. This was the first case that we have taken if the complementation test we are doing. Now the second case is that single locus is present. No two different locus, only single locus is present. So if we take the case 2 and single locus is there. That is white color flower was there. And it needs only one gene for the formation of purple color. Then what will happen? Then if mutation occurred, then the flower will be white color. So if I take two mutated parents, white color mutated parents, then what will happen? AA is crossed with AA. Then the offspring will be small a, and it will be white colored. It will be mutated. It won't be like a wild type. So what happened in here? No complementation has occurred in this case as that of the before. So in before the complementation occurred and here no complementation occurred. So complementation will occur if a specific characteristic is controlled by different locus or it's controlled by two genes. Then only the complementation can occur. If it is present on single locus, it won't occur. That is the complementation test, that two genes will complement each other and will form white type of offspring. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this topic is now understood to you. Thank you so much guys. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.